Pero ako, kasi kung katawa rin yung programa ko, sa yung punto for punto, and by the way, with regards to the issue of Darwin, have you heard about that? That he is at present temporarily bound to come to Cebu to give talks because of that issue. Nahiba mo sa issue? No, not because the charismatic group in Cebu petitioning Archbishop Palma to, I won't say, to ban Darwin to come to Cebu and to give teaching. The reason is because Father Darwin, according to them, allegedly, according to them, Father Darwin is opposed to looking to come. No? And they reacted to that. No? And they went to Archbishop and had Archbishop Palma signed a declaration that is still valid. No? And I talked to Darwin and I called him. I said, what is this problem with you, Father? Why is it a turban in Cebu? What did you say about the people of time? Why are the charismatic groups here in Cebu are very opposed to you? What did you say? What have you done? And he said, the problem with the charismatic in Cebu is that they just go directly to Archbishop and they didn't talk to me. You don't have a dialogue with me. And Archbishop, who made a statement without even talking to me. So what have you done? And he said, I am not against the gift of tongue. I'm only against the danger of using the gift of tongue without proper instruction sa ato mga katawahan. Because based on my own experience, according to him, there were people, charismatic groups, members of the charismatic community, leaders of the charismatic community, that possessed because of the gift of tongue. Now, I repeat, according to him, I am not against the gift of tongue. Yes, there is gift of tongue according to the Bible. And if you read the letter of Paul to the Corinthians chapter 14, it's there. Look, I follow that. I am for the authentic gift of tongue. Not the other way. So I propose the gift of tongue, the real gift of tongue, the authentic gift of tongue, not the other gift of tongue that was being abused by these people. And I said, okay, you talk to your bishop, Bishop Ahmed, and then after talking to your archbishop, to your bishop, make your own statement and have an audience with Archbishop Parma in order to clarify this matter with you. And the reason also why I called him because I have also an appointment with him. I asked him to preside about during the feast of the Divine Mercy in Lubuan. But then I know because he preside because of the decision. So that's the development. To
make his message known is our responsibility. So here we are to pledge our lives to the Lord.